Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how to connect Microsoft SQL Server data to the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component using Entity Framework. Entity Framework is an object relational mapper that simplifies database work in .NET by enabling the use of classes instead of SQL for queries, connections, and data mapping. To create an API service, I will open an existing ASP.NET Core web app. If you want to learn how to create an ASP.NET Core web app, check the documentation link provided in the description below. Now you can see I have already created an order details database using SQL Server to store the data. To verify the table's creation, expand the order details database. Right-click on the orders table and select View Data. This option allows you to see the current state of the table, displaying the database table containing the order details. Here, I need to access the data from the order details database. So I set up a controller to retrieve data from the DB context and pass it to the Blazor application. For that, I create the new folder named controllers within the project and add a class named GridController. After creating the GridController class, I'll include the Microsoft ASP.NET Core MVC namespace. Then let me inherit from controller base, which is essential for handling web API requests in ASP.NET Core. Next, to define the class as a web API controller, I'll add the API controller attribute, which enables automatic model validation and request data binding. The next step is to define a model that represents the data I want to work with. So inside this class, I create the order model class, which includes several properties that correspond to the columns in the order details database: order ID, customer ID, employee ID, freight, and ship city. Here, I also added the key attribute to the order ID property to mark it as the primary key, which uniquely identifies each order. Next, I need to add a connection string to interact with the database. To do this, I open the database location, right-click on the order details database, and select the properties option. Here you can see the connection string in the database properties window. I will copy the string and close the database properties window. Inside the GridController class, I declare a connection string variable and paste the copied connection string into it. This string provides the essential information needed to connect the application to the database. To manage the database connection, I'll create a public class named OrderDBContext. Here, I am going to inherit from the DBContext class to interact with the database. To do this, I'll install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core NuGet package into my application. So, open the NuGet Package Manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Microsoft Entity Framework Core package and install it. Also install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core SQL Server package, which enables Entity Framework Core to interact with the SQL Server database. This package adds the necessary functionality to connect and work with SQL Server. Then let me import the Microsoft Entity Framework Core namespace, which contains the core components and classes needed for ORM-based database interaction. Now, inherit from the DBContext class. This is the primary class in Entity Framework for database management. Inside this class, I declare the private variable named ConnectionString to store the database connection string. Then I create a constructor, which takes a connection string parameter. This string contains the details required to connect to the database, such as the server address, database name, and authentication details. Inside the constructor, I will assign the connection string parameter's value to a private field called connection string. Next, I override the onConfiguring method from the DBContext class. In this method, I call the useSQLServer method and pass the connection string so that Entity Framework knows where to connect for database operations. Then I declare a property named orders to represent the collection of order entities in the database. This enables CRUD operations on the orders table, allowing Entity Framework to track and query data within it. Next, I create a public method named getOrderData. This method can be accessed as part of the web API and returns a list of order objects. Then set the route attribute above the getOrderData method and use the template. This placeholder will be replaced by the controller name. For instance, if it's grid controller, the route will be API/grid. Inside the method, I use a using block for proper resource management. Then I initialize the context variable with a connection string to connect to the SQL server database. After that, I retrieve all records from the orders table. Then I return the list. Next, open the program CS file and register the addCourses method, adding core services to the application. Here, the addPolicy method was defined to create a course policy that allowed requests from any origin with any HTTP method and headers. I'll use the app variable to configure the request pipeline with middleware that allows any origin method header and credentials by defining the useCourses method. Then I'll apply the CORS policy named CORS policy to manage cross-origin requests. Next, let me set up endpoint routing for HTTP requests and establish a default route for MVC controllers using map default controller route to ensure a conventional URL pattern. Now let's run the example application. You can see the default homepage. I manually set the path to the API. And as you can see, the provided records are displayed from the database. To automatically navigate to the API endpoint when launching the application, open the launch settings JSON file and add the relative URL to open in the browser. Now let me run the example. You'll see the browser automatically navigating to the endpoint. Next, to bind data from the database to the Blazor DataGrid component, I will copy the URL now, and after a couple of minutes, let me set it in the URL adapter to fetch data and assign it to the grid. Next, I will show you how to connect Blazor DataGrid to an API service. Here, you can see where I have already added the Blazor web application to the same project. Now let me open the HomeRazor component. I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component with grid columns for displaying the order details. If you want to know how to add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component to a Blazor web app, check the video linked in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Next, I will define the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set the URL property. This will hold the URL of the RESTful service endpoint from which the grid will fetch records from the database. I'll now paste the copied URL into the URL adapter, enabling the connection between the database and the Blazor DataGrid component. Then add the adapter property set to URL adapter, enabling the DataGrid to send requests to a specified URL endpoint to fetch, update, delete, or insert data. Before running the example, I'll first display the records in the Blazor DataGrid component. To achieve this, let me open the Grid Controller class. I import the Syncfusion Blazor namespace, which is needed to use the built-in Data Manager Request class. Inside this class, I'll create a POST method to handle incoming data requests. Then use the FromBody attribute to bind the request data to the parameter. The Data Manager Request parameter is added from the request body. This is a Syncfusion object that contains details like paging, sorting, and filtering for the data grid. If you want to know more on adding paging, sorting, and other data operations, check the video linked in the description below. In the POST method, I'll get the data source by calling the getOrderData method, which returns a list of order objects for the data grid. I'll then calculate the total number of records. Next, return an object with two properties, result and count. Then add HTTP POST and route attributes to specify that this method handles POST requests. Now that the setup is complete, I'll configure the application to run multiple projects simultaneously. So click the drop-down arrow next to the Run button and select and configure startup projects. Here, enable multiple startup projects and set the start action for both the server and the web service projects. With the startup project set to multiple, I'll run the example application. You can see the data grid component is rendered with the data retrieved from the database using entity framework. Next, I will show you how to perform CRUD operations. To start with the insert operation, inside the grid controller class, I create an insert method with the necessary code logic to bind incoming data to the grid. This method is triggered by an HTTP POST request to the specified API endpoint. It connects using OrderDB context, adds the incoming order data to the orders table, and saves the new record to the database. Next, navigate to the Home Razor component. Add the toolbar property to display options like add, edit, delete, cancel, and so on. Define the grid edit settings tag and set the allow adding property to true. Then add the insert URL property in the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set it to the insert URL. Now you'll see the data grid rendered with the toolbar. When I click the add button, add a record with the required details and click update, the record will be successfully updated. Also, I check the database, and you'll see the new record inserted successfully. Next, I will show you how to perform the update operation. In the grid controller class, I create an update method with the required code logic to update existing data in the grid. It connects using OrderDB context, locates the existing order by order ID, updates its values with the incoming data, and saves the changes to the database. Navigate to the Home Razor component and set the allow editing property to true. Also, add the update URL property and set it to the update URL. Before running the example, I'll set the order ID as the primary key since the update method uses it to modify existing records. Now I will select a record, click edit to change the ship city. And after making the changes, I will click update. The record will be updated successfully. Refresh the database. And you will see the edited record updated. Lastly, I explain the delete operation. In the grid controller class, I create a delete method with the necessary code logic to remove existing data from the grid. It connects using the OrderDB context, locates the order by its order ID, removes the record, and saves the changes. Navigate to the Home Razor component and set the allow deleting property to true. Then add the remove URL property and set it to the delete URL. Look now. Select a record and click the delete button. The selected record is deleted successfully. Refresh the database. The record is deleted. Now let me summarize. In this video, I demonstrated how to connect Microsoft SQL Server data to the Blazor DataGrid component using Entity Framework. I also showed you how to integrate the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component and perform CRUD operations. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from that GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor components. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.